Okay, now we have to determine the Marshall specimen specific gravity, and keep this in mind, this specific gravity is represented by GMB. Specific gravity of bitumen is fixed. So, sir, this Marshall specimen, for your understanding, it's shown over here. So these Marshall specimens are shown over here just for your understanding that how the Marshall specimen looks like. Now this is my specimen. Now I have to this is my specimen. I have to determine the specific gravity by ASTO 166 method. So this prepared specimen, first point, we will bear its dryness and it will be represented by A. So keep this thing in mind. We are making this specimen in the laboratory. So there is no need to heat it, because sometime when we have cut the core from the other side, we are heating it to the 52 Celsius in order to remove the moisture. Because this white Marshall specimen is already dry, because I have prepared in this laboratory. Second, I will find out the SST. SST weight of the specimen. I will represent it by it B. What do you mean by SST? Surface saturated dry. Because when specimen is taken out from the water, its additional surplus moisture is removed by rolling it on the towel. Then we are finding out its mass or weight, that is represented by B, that is SST. And third one, we have put the sample in the water for 4 ± 1 minute. And keep that in mind, the temperature of this water should not be more than 25 Celsius. So I have put the specimen in the water for 4 ± 1 minute, and the temperature of the water should not be more than 25 Celsius. I have the system to determine the mass of the sample when it is immersed in water. So that mass in water is represented by C. So these are just very fundamental terminologies. So by using all of these expressions which are given over here, and everything I have explained to you, there we will find out G and B by using the relationship A over B minus C. B minus C gives us the volume. So this is our dry mass. I have to measure the GMB at different different asphalt content, because when my mixed design was being developed, I had informed you that my asphalt content is varying from 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5 and 5. For each one, I have prepared three samples. So, for your understanding, I have told you that for each bitumen content, we have prepared the 3 samples. Like, one such sample is in my hand. This is shown over here. This is one such sample which is in my hand. 1, 2 and 3. Now, when we have to determine the GMB. You know, when we have to determine the value of GMB, we will find out for each of these 3 samples, then we will write down their average value. One such chart showing the different amount of bitumen content and the sample prepared is given over here. You see 2.5% 3 sample, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5 and 5. So it means I have prepared this set of the sample for different bitumen content. Now I will determine the GMB for each by taking their dry weight, by taking their SSD weight and by taking their weight when it is immersed in water. And their one practical example, just I will show you how we are going to do.